Hi, my name is Stephen Lee. I'm a business development manager at Keysight Technologies Power and Energy Division. And in this video today, we're going to use the electronic load function on our new N6780 series source measure unit. One of the key features on our source measure units is the ability to do two quadrant operation. What that means is that our SMUs can act as a power supply and also an electronic load at the same time. So let's take a look at the setup. In the setup here, we have a simple battery. This battery is a battery you use on a power drill, but the concept applies to any type of battery, so a laptop battery, a walkie-talkie battery. I got a set of wires running from the battery to channel one of our N6705B DC power analyzer. And inside channel one is our N6785A source measure unit. So let's go ahead and go to the front panel here, and we'll set up the source measure unit to act as an electronic load. The first thing we're going to do is press the settings button. By default, the emulating mode on all SMUs as it comes up is always two quadrant power supply. We press the enter button and drop down the menu. Once we're here, we're going to select CC load, which stands for constant current load. At this point, the power supply is set to emulate an electronic load. Next, we jump to the current setting. For this setup, we're going to go ahead and choose 2 amps. And you'll see that it's negative 2 instead of positive 2 to indicate that current is actually going into the power supply instead of coming out. For our current range, we're going to go ahead and choose around 4 amps, which is well above what we set the current to. Next, we set the voltage. This is a 9.6 volt battery, and we're going to go ahead and choose a value well above that, so let's put in 12. At this point, we're pretty much all set to go. Let's go back to our meter view, and we're going to enable the output. So right away, you'll see that the voltage value is dropping ever so slightly. It's going down, and it will keep going down for a really, really long time. And this indicates the discharge of the battery. If you want to speed this up, what we can do is we can set a higher current value, and this will actually make things much faster. So instead of negative 2 amps, let's go ahead and push in negative 4. So once we do that, you'll notice that the value up here, the voltage value, is dropping much faster than before. And when we punch in a higher and higher current value, you'll see it discharge faster and faster. So that's a really simple discharge function. If you want to do a deeper analysis, what we can do is go to the data logger function. From an earlier setup, I've captured the discharge profile of this battery for a few minutes, and the top waveform here is the voltage, and you can see the voltage go from a high value all the way to a lower value, and the waveform down here is the current setting, and you can see it's a pretty constant value on the current setting. So the data logger is useful when you're trying to compare your battery's actual performance to that of the manufacturer specification. So this has been a video to show how to use the N6780 series SMU as an electronic load. Thank you very much for watching. If you want to get more information, please visit keysight.com. Thank you.